Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy.
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who
trespass against us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit from thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Say our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, for banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our souls. side, born and weeping, and Miss Dale in tears. There is a most gracious advocate, thy eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary.
Pray for us, O Lord,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray.
God, his only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life. Grant we the safety and meditating upon these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary, of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise. Through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Prayer to
St.
Michael,
our
angel.
St. Michael, our angel, defend us in heaven. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke you, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, ask in your help of Satan, all the evil spirits, who crawl upon the world, seeking the wounds of souls. Amen.
here once tonight. Ours is the only voice God will hear. We don't have an organ, so I invite you to sing out loud. Please turn to Miss Letts, and we'll sing number 269. Sing praise to our Creator. We'll sing out loud together. Number 269. Sing praise to our Creator.
Sing praise to our Creator.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the poor, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of vindication by our God. I rejoice heartily in the Lord, and my God is the joy of my soul. For he has clothed me with a robe of salvation and wrapped me in a mantle of justice, like a bridegroom adorned with a diadem, like a bride bedecked with her jewels. As the earth brings forth its plants, and a garden makes its growth spring up, so will the Lord God make justice and praise spring up before all the nations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul rejoices in my God.
My soul rejoices in my God.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed.
My soul rejoices in my God.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation.
My soul rejoices in my God.
He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to help of his servants Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy.
My soul rejoices.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. In all circumstances, give thanks. For this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench the Spirit. Do not despise prophetic utterances. Test everything. Retain what is good. Refrain from every kind of evil. May the God of peace make you perfectly holy, and may you entirely, spirit, soul, and body, be preserved blameless for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will also accomplish it. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light. And this is the testimony of John. When the Jews from Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to him to ask him, "Who are you?" he admitted and did not deny it, but admitted, "I am not the Christ." So they asked him, "Who are you then? Are you Elijah?" And he said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." So they said to him, "Who are you, so that we can give an answer to those who sent us? What do you have to say for yourself?" He said, I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord, as Isaiah the prophet said. So some of the Pharisees were also sent and asked him, why then do you baptize if you are not the Christ or Elijah or the prophet? Jesus answered them, I baptize with water, but there is one among you whom you do not recognize, the one who is coming after me, whose sandal strap I am not worthy to untie. This happened in Bethany across the Jordan, where John was baptizing. The Gospel of the Lord. Beloved, we had this exact same gospel last weekend, but taken from St. Mark's gospel, this is the same passage, but from St. John's gospel. So I've asked the ushers to come forward now and give you your test from last weekend's homily. They're coming up now, don't laugh. This is called, universally speaking, Gaudete Sunday. And so I hope you ate your Wheaties. I'm going to teach you Latin. Are you ready? Remembering what Father Gerald said to me, first year of college seminary, Mr. Zoghby, trying to teach you Latin is like trying to nail Jell-O to a tree. I'm going to teach you Latin anyway. The word to rejoice in Latin is gaudere, to rejoice. The church calling this Gaudete Sunday means you, plural, you rejoice. So on this Gaudete Sunday, obviously, we changed the color of the vestment to something a little more festive than purple. And we hear from St. Paul, and he says, brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord always. I say again, rejoice without ceasing. Rejoice means to rejoice. When the Lord, for instance, my beloved, gave the command, I give you a new commandment, love one another as I have loved you. We're reminded that love is primarily not a thing. When he says love one another as I love you, love is a verb. Love is a doing. Similarly, joy is not primarily a thing. Joy is a doing. And so we read as a parish about 5, maybe 7 years ago, a book that I think just the title of the book explains what I'm trying to get at with you, my beloved. The book is called Choosing Joy. St. Paul has the prescription for us to be people who rejoice, people of joy. Unless you don't want to hear this and want to be miserable your whole life. You don't want to be miserable, do you? Then I'm going to teach you how to choose joy. Rejoice, brothers and sisters, in all things. How? In every circumstance, give thanks. We know from experience that when we're giving thanks, when we're considering the gifts that God has given, rather than what we don't have or what we used to have or what we wish we did have, when we give thanks, we're people who are rejoicing. Amen? Because listen here, it takes discipline. It absolutely takes discipline. Now, to give thanks takes discipline. To
to be people of thanks. You have to do it every morning and every night. Little things and big. Then he says, to be people who rejoice. Do not quench the spirit. Do not quench the spirit simply means this. Receive the gift of the Spirit inside of you as a dwelling place of the Holy Spirit, knowing that you have been called. What do I mean by that? Part of being a people of rejoicing is doing just what John the Baptist did. John the Baptist recognized who he was not. Who he was not. I am not the Christ. So the pressure is off, beloved. We're not God. The pressure's off. It's great not to be God. We leave all the big decisions up to Him. Except when we try to control, when we try to manipulate, when we try to create reality and don't accept reality, then we're people who are living in angst and anxiety. So accept what you are. You're not God. And then accept your gifts. We're all blessed with gifts, talents, a vocation. It might not be perfect. It never is. And it's never, ever exactly what we thought it would be. I get tickled when I have a couple at the altar and they're getting married. Well, let me tell you a funny, you mind hearing a funny story? First marriage I ever did at St. Margaret's. An old fella called me. I knew it was an old voice. It was when I came here so long ago, we had the cassette tapes for the recording for the voicemail.
Oh my gosh.
So anyway, he called me and said, "Father, what's it take to get married in the church today?" So I told him his name and called him back, and he's 82. Did I ever tell you the story? He's 82, his bride to be 68, their spouses had died. And I'd already done 500 weddings before I got to this parish. Because I was in a parish where they had a lot of weddings. Anyway, so I was doing their vows. First time I'd ever done a wedding for an older couple. And the first time I ever saw, I've done all these kids' weddings, first time I ever saw people doing their vows and they both cried. Why? Because they actually knew what they were getting into. I mean that tongue in cheek. What I do mean by that, however, is they've already lived a life of loving and sacrificing. They'd already lived the merit of vocation. What I'm trying to say is, you recognize what you're not. You're not God. But you also recognize your gifts, that you do have a vocation, like John did, to proclaim who he was not and proclaim the presence of Jesus when at last he came. And lastly, my beloved, St. Paul says, remain in the grace of God. Strive to live a holy life. And when you don't, simply repent. I've got to tell you a great story. You know there's a priest, and we'll have several priests on Wednesday, starting at 4 o'clock all the way through 7:15 for confession. But a young family, because I know there's a bunch of people who'd rather not have a confession today. I mean, some people do, some people don't. Anyway, I was coming into church, and precious family going to confession, the whole family. And there was such a levity about this family who had just gone to confession. There was such a lightness in their being because they had given over to God what they had done wrong. And so they were living in what St. Paul calls peace. And so, beloved, choosing joy requires certain disciplines. It doesn't just come. We have to choose it. Amen?
Amen.
Together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ.
Spirit was upon the Virgin Mary, who came in. For our sake, he crucified and crucified. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He has ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and Giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the glory and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Our Father is very good to us. In confidence, we offer our prayers of petition.
To experience and share the joy of Jesus by recognizing his presence among us, we pray to the Lord. For those who are experiencing doubts in their faith, to be anointed with the wisdom of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord. For couples experiencing difficulties in their marriage, to receive the healing grace of Jesus, we pray to the Lord. For vocations to the priesthood, especially from the young men of our parish, and for all our seminarians, especially Gayton Armstrong, Joshua Lynch, and Rich Perkins, we pray to the Lord. For our deceased relatives and friends to see the face of God and live, let us pray to the Lord.
Pray for God to protect all, protecting us and our forces at home and abroad. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We offer the Lord our prayers in a moment of silence. Dear Father, we are thankful to you for your gifts to us, and offer these prayers in the name of Jesus, your Son, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. I invite you to sing Amazing Grace, number 287. Amazing Grace, number 287.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved.
Blessed be you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May the sacrifice of our worship, O Lord, be offered to you unceasingly to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplished for us your saving work. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
astray.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus your Son. For all the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when at last he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice in the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exalted in his praise. And so, with all the angels and saints, we cry out to him of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are to be holy, O Lord, fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, save us, save the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also all the brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, the most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Offer to each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to eat your hand under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. We implore your mercy, O Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feast. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Welcome our visitors to St. Margaret's. We're very happy you've come to be with us. If you've been coming to the parish while or live in the area and just moved here, please join our parish. Your membership forms and best you'll take one for that and put it in the collection. Or join online at our website. So next weekend again, you'll choose a Sunday Mass, whether it be Saturday evening the 23rd or a morning Mass on the 24th, 8 to 10:30, and then choose a Christmas Mass, whether it be 4 or 6 p.m. on Christmas Eve or 9 a.m. on Christmas. We'll be together a lot. I look forward to seeing you. Sure you do. This week we'll have extra confessions. Of course, you might hear confessions before every Mass, but we'll have a priest in the confessional 4 until 7:15. So it's not the same priest, but various priests will come for an hour at a time, so you'll have ample opportunity. Do not let the grace of God go in vain. So make sure to make yourself an appointment with Jesus to go to confession if you are always in the early afternoon and evening from 4 to 7:15. Be a visiting priest in confession. We're real proud of our men. They've taken my heat and they actually have organized a Christmas dinner for our parish in the Christmas season. I love them for that. Thank you, men. And so they'll be in the nursery, just off the vestibule there. You can procure your ticket. We really have to have you do it this weekend because we've got to put the order in. So make sure you do it for the rest of the week. It'd be great if you saw them right after Mass. The men of St. Joseph will be in the nursery of the church after the 5:30 Mass on Wednesday. I don't think I've talked to you about this. Our parish has purchased a subscription to something called Formed. Formed is a Catholic platform with literally millions of podcasts, scripture studies, Bible stuff, faith studies for every age, lots of things for children. And all you have to do is, because we bought the subscription, is use it. So please look at the bulletin. It's very simple. Just form.org, put St. Mark's in parish, and you can use it. And it's got movies, it's got everything. You can hook it up to your TV and enjoy guidance stuff on your computer or use your phone. So make sure to use that, and you can share it too with anybody. We don't care. We're paid for it either way. Very good. If you'll listen before you, please stand in front of us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Divine praises and prayers to St. Michael from the back part of your missal together.
Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God, true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus Christ,
the sacrament of God. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, paraclete.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be the holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be the glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin of Mother. Blessed be St. Joseph, our most chaste house. Blessed be God, his angels and his saints.
Saint Michael, the Archangel,
defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God forgive him, humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the divine power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruins of souls. Amen.
Please turn to Ms. Letts and sing number 391. Now thank you, O God. Number 391. Now thank you, O God. Verses 1 and 2.
Now thank you, O God. From our mother.
us all.